Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm your host, Patrick LeBlanc, and today I have Balaji with me to talk about materialized views. Before we get into this, why don't you tell the people who you are and what you do?
Hey, thanks, Patrick, for having me over on the show. I'm Balaji. I'm part of the data engineering team at Fabric, and my team is busy building Fabric Materialized Lake Views, the easiest way to implement Medallion Architecture on Fabric.
Oh, the easiest way. So when I think about materialized views, right, and I know these are lake views, I think about instead of building out this infrastructure, like I'm using the data to infer, the queries to infer what my infrastructure looks like. So tell us about.
Yeah, so the traditional way how you build out a multi-stage data processing pipeline is you process data using notebooks and pipelines and orchestrate. So we are coming with a radically new approach and rethinking this. So what we're saying is you write declarative code saying, hey, this view depends on these tables and other views, and then we infer the pipeline automatically behind. So there are no pipelines, the jobs orchestrate themselves, and that's the simplicity and beauty of it.
So instead of creating tables and defining schema and things like that, as my data comes in, the queries will define my schema. And if I wanted to explicitly define a data type, I could do that in the code if I want to.
Yeah, that is true. And it's not just that, right? It's a whole bunch of, when we spoke to customers about what are their pain points, the thing is like doing this through code declaratively is one significant benefit. The other one is for them to see the visual dependencies visually, like what I'm showing on my screen, right? Like from
Let's take a look.
Sure.
Let's take a look.
So if if you see the this is a whole lake house,
yep.
And in this the boxes of which are showing in green are the materialized lake views which I've written through code. So now this, if I click on one, I can see which other tables and views it depends upon. Yep. So there's a visual lineage, right? So all these builds automatically and beautifully laid out in a background. And once all this is built up, then every you can set up a schedule for it, and then it refreshes every single time. So translating from code into a visual lineage, and then the orchestration that happens automatically.
So I don't have to, you know, create folders and things like that to move my data through. I can declare it all through the views.
Yeah, correct. And one of the tricky parts of building, pipelines and data processing is to see, hey, how to orchestrate in what sequence and all that. Here, our infrastructure behind the scenes takes care of it so that you don't have to do all the heavy lifting.
I don't have to create pipelines. I don't need data flows. I do it all through a little SQL.
Yep.
So all of this can be done through a language that most people already know.
Yeah.
I don't have to learn how to write Python. I could use Spark SQL and get it done.
You can use Spark SQL today, and Python is releasing in a couple of weeks from now. So you'll be you can mix and match. So for example, if you like Python as a declarative language because of the expressiveness,
yep.
You could mix and match depending on what your scenario is. So it doesn't matter for our pipelines to orchestrate.
All right.
And that's not the end of it. And then the other thing that we've done is we've got this incredible thing called optimal refresh.
Yeah.
So this looks for, because it's running on a Delta table, you can look at change data feeds and then only refresh the stuff that's changed, right? Like, so when you're running pipelines, if nothing has changed, you don't use compute cycles.
So it
runs like 70% faster in some of the tests. And when you combine it with the native execution engine, it's like runs twice as fast as some of the regular pipelines plus notebooks, yeah.
If I have a billion row table that I'm sourcing my materialized view from, and I only get one row, only one row changes in that materialized, in my source table, it just changes one row. Wow, that's pretty impressive. So it's really fast and efficient.
It depends. We have some scenario coverage, but on the scenarios we support, like anywhere between 30 to 70% improvement in processing time is what you're
saying. Wow.
There's one last thing.
Okay.
This is like a shrink-wrapped implementation of Medallion.
Yeah.
So what it means is in the SQL code you write, you can define data quality constraints. So as this orchestrates, if you find something's not right in the source data.
Yep.
It can, you can choose either to drop it or to kind of carry on the processing and just log it for reporting, right? So it's like a full shrink wrapped medallion implementation with data quality, declarative pipelines, this visual lineage, and the incremental refresh, right? That makes it a complete package to make this work very, very well.
And it's just all built in. It's just all out of the box. There's nothing extra I need to do, pay for. It just comes as part of my lake house.
Yeah, it's part of your lake house. We don't charge any premium on this. So the compute you'll be using will be built at the Spark capacity. So it, there's no additional cost, and you'll have a ton of savings because of all the stuff that I
saw. All right. Well, Bala, thank you so much for joining us today. And thank you all for watching. If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Fabric YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from Bala and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday.
Thanks, Patrick.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive in the Microsoft Fabric.